Good morning and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to study user defined functions. First of all, we should know why should I write user defined function, what is its utility, when to write user defined functions. So far we have introduced numbers, assignments, input output, comparisons and utility of variables in Python. The code we have studied till now have been single conditional and iterative sequence of instructions and were small in size. We can easily work with problems whose solutions can be written in the form of small Python program. As a problem becomes complex, the program also increases in size and complexity, and it becomes difficult and cumbersome for a programmer to keep track of data and control statements in a whole program. Thus, Python provides the feature to divide a large program into different smaller modules. These modules are known as functions, which have the responsibility to work upon data for processing. It is difficult and time-consuming to interpret a large program every time. There is a slight modification in the code, but if that program is divided into a number of small functions, which is called subprograms, then the whole task becomes very easy and saves a lot of time and effort. So if required, and if it becomes necessary, the subprogram can be further divided into still smaller programs. And the process of dividing a program into a set of programs of smaller size can be continued up to any appropriate level. Therefore, function provides a systematic way to problem solving by dividing the given problem into several subproblems, finding their individual solutions, and integrating the solution of individual problems to solve the original problems. So, we should write a function. It divides and conquer. It follows divide and conquer approach. Divide a big and complex problem into smaller problems. So managing, editing, correcting, modifying smaller problem is more easier than the big and complex problem. That is why we write functions. So functions are the most important building block for any application in Python and work on divide and conquer approach. Or according to this definition, function is a set of statement that performs a specific task. It is a common structuring element that allows us to use a piece of code repeatedly in different parts of program. That means you write the function once and use it many times throughout the program. As and when it is required for the task which is required to be done at any point of program, there you can call that function. Because once the function is written, that can be used just like a stamp as and when required in our program. So, functions are actually three types, you can say. Two types rather. Built-in functions and user-defined functions. Built-in functions and user-defined functions. And another one is module also, that we will cover in next video. Here we are going to focus on user-defined functions only. So, built-in functions kya hain? These are predefined functions to make programming easier, faster and powerful. like we use int to convert a string into integer, float, convert a string type value into float, string str function converts numeric into string, input returns the value that we enter, max, min, abs, eval, type, etc. These are built-in functions. They are only used for them. We need not to write any program. Second one is module. Module is a collection of related functions. Whatever function we write, we can store them at a place in a file having extension .py. So that becomes module. That module can be imported in our program to use the functions of that module anywhere within the program. Modules can be imported using import command, like import math, import random, import mysql.connector and all, and so on. Import pandas, import numpy, all those. Now, coming to user defined functions. These functions are created by users to perform specific tasks. It is created using def statement. अगर आप यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शंस यूज करना चाहते हैं, क्रिएट करना चाहते हैं, तो हमें स्टार्टिंग कहाँ से करनी पड़ेगी? We have to start from def, D-E-F, then function name, then colon. Its syntax is, you can see the syntax at the top, def, function name, within bracket, comma, separated, list of parameters, means x, comma, y, comma, z, and so on. How many parameters you want to use within the function, that can be written over there. Doc string, it is about the function, whatever you want to write, you can write just like a comment. That will be helpful on later stage to identify what sort of function it is. And then statements of the function. Whatever statement, whatever logic has to be written within the body of function can be written. I am taking an example, non-returning, non-parameterized functions. एक तो आप पैरामीटर के साथ फंक्शंस लिख सकते हैं. फंक्शन के बाद ब्रैकेट में यू हैव टू गिव द पैरामीटर लिस्ट सेपरेटेड बाय कॉमास. एंड देयर इज अनदर फंक्शन व्हिच कैन बी रिटन विदाउट एनी पैरामीटर. सो इट इज फिक्स्ड एंड इट विल गिव द फिक्स्ड वैल्यू. फॉर एग्जांपल हियर दिस फंक्शन func1 इज विदाउट पैरामीटर, नॉन पैरामीटराइज्ड, एंड इट डज नॉट रिटर्न एनी वैल्यू. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नॉन रिटर्निंग. दो तरह के फंक्शन हैं, एक रिटर्निंग और एक नॉन रिटर्निंग, एक पैरामीटराइज्ड और एक नॉन पैरामीटराइज्ड. हम सभी फंक्शंस के एग्जांपल एक एक करके यहाँ देखेंगे. सो नंबर वन, यू कैन सी दिस फंक्शन इज नॉन पैरामीटराइज्ड एज वेल एज नॉन रिटर्निंग. सिंस देयर इज नो पैरामीटर एंड सिंस देयर इज नो रिटर्न स्टेटमेंट विद इन द बॉडी ऑफ फंक्शन, दैट इज वाई इट इज नॉन रिटर्निंग. Although generally functions return some values back after performing some task. So here the task is being performed, that is, it is printing India is my country, but not returning any value, rather printing. अब आप देखें कि function को call कैसे किया जाएगा. यहाँ पर आप देखें def function name colon, और उसके बाद फिर indentation आपको change कर देना है tab space से. सो एक अलाइनमेंट पर ये सारा प्रोग्राम लिखा जाएगा. दैट इज वाई यहाँ पर मैंने लिखा इंडेंटेशन. फंक्शन डेफिनेशन इसको कहते हैं. और फंक्शन को कॉल कैसे करेंगे? सिंपली राइट द फंक्शन नेम विदाउट एनी पैरामीटर. सो दिस फंक्शन इज कॉल्ड. एज सून एज दिस फंक्शन इज कॉल्ड इन द इंटरैक्टिव मोड, इट इमीडिएटली एग्जीक्यूट्स एंड प्रिंट्स इंडिया इज माई कंट्री, the same result which you have printed here. So this function is executed. Although this function can be called in program also, not only in interactive mode. So this is a non-returning, non-parameterized function. Now, after this, Another example, non-returning parameterized function. So here we'll be using some parameters. Suppose I'm using a parameter msg. MSG is a sort of message. It will print a message. So print msg. Function will not take the value of this parameter directly within the body of function here. यहाँ पर हमें ये मान के चलना है कि इस पैरामीटर की वैल्यू जब फंक्शन कॉल किया जाएगा तब प्रोवाइड की जाएगी. अभी यहाँ पर मैं MSG की वैल्यू नहीं दे रहा हूँ. अब फंक्शन कॉल कैसे करेंगे? FUNC1 को कॉल करने के लिए सिंस MSG इज ए वेरिएबल हुज वैल्यू इज रिक्वायर्ड व्हाइल कॉलिंग दिस फंक्शन func1, इसलिए मैंने यहां पर my underscore msg वेरिएबल में एक इनपुट करा दिया मैसेज, सो दैट दिस वेरिएबल्स वैल्यू कैन बी पास्ड टू msg व्हाइल कॉलिंग दिस फंक्शन. अब मैं इस फंक्शन को कॉल करता हूं func1 विद इन ब्रैकेट इन प्लेस ऑफ msg आई एम पासिंग अ वैल्यू my underscore मैसेज as a string type. So what will happen? Immediately my message, this value will be passed to the original function, original functions parameter msg. msg को pass कर देगा ये. और उसके according ये function run हो करके print msg will give the output. See the result. इसकी अगेंस्ट इस लाइन के अगेंस्ट इट इज आस्किंग एंटर मैसेज आई हैव रिटन वी ऑल आर इंडियंस एंड देन दिस फंक्शन इज कॉल्ड वी ऑल आर इंडियंस मैसेज हैज बीन पास्ड टू MSG व्हिच हैज प्रिंटेड द सेम मैसेज प्रिंट वी ऑल आर इंडियंस सो आउटपुट इज कमिंग वी ऑल आर इंडियंस.
Now we can see in this function returning a non-parameterized function. This function will return some value but no parameters within the bracket has to be given. Function 1 MSG equal to India is my country return MSG. Function call my MSG since it is returning some function some value. So those functions which return some value must be assigned to some variable while calling. So whatever it will return will be stored in some variable and that variable can be further manipulated or printed. So here I have written my underscore message a variable in which function 1 has been called. So it returns the message which is storing India is my country. So my MSG will hold India is my country whatever is returned by this function and the same message is going to be printed as India is my country. This is the output. So this is non-parameterized but returning function. In returning function we have to use the return statement in the body of the function. This should be the last function for returning certain value. Now after this another example is returning and parameterized function. Here the function will return as well as it is parameterized also. I am writing a function to calculate the simple interest def calc underscore si within bracket p comma r comma t three parameters. One thing more I want to tell you. In the function definition, whatever parameters you are giving, p, r and t, they are known as parameters. But while calling these functions, whatever parameters has been being defined, principal, comma, rate, comma, time, principal against p, rate against r and time against t, principal, rate and time, they are called as arguments. Remember, while calling the function, whatever parameter is passed, they are known as arguments. And while defining the function, declaring the function, in the function definition, whatever parameters are there, they are known as parameters. and one term is there, formal parameters and actual parameters. So this PRT are formal parameters, and principal, rate and time are actual parameters, you can say. So remember these definitions. The alternative names for arguments, all arguments के लिए, principal, rate और time के लिए जो हैं वो क्या कहलाते हैं, actual arguments, actual parameters. And alternative names for parameters, these ones are known as formal parameters. So these are two definitions you must remember. Okay. Return statement returns the value of an expression following the return keyword. Return के बाद जो ये आपका parameter है या sorry ये variable है या expression है, इसकी value return करता है. जिस function में कुछ भी return statement ही नहीं लिखा है तो वो non return करते हैं. Such function returns non value. Now these two points you must remember. So in this function I have written a function for calculation of the simple interest. SI is calculated P into R into T multiplied by 0.01 means upon 100 and return SI. So while calling this function we need three values against P, R and T, means three actual parameters. So I am giving these three actual parameters through input statement. After converting into float, it is being assigned to principal, rate and time. So while calling the function, function call ke samay main ek variable mein assign karunga, kyunki returning functions hain, it will return something. So calculate SI, function name, then within bracket principal, rate, time, it is representing actual parameters. Against the value of principal will be passed to P, rate will be passed to R, time will be passed to T, and accordingly the value of this my SI, the local variable of this program, will be printed. Simple interest equal to rupees my SI. So this is the output. Enter principal, rate and time will be asked by from the user, and after entering these three values, simple interest is being returned, simple interest equal to rupees 300. So this is what returning and parameterized function. I think it is clear, quite clear, because it is not so difficult. Now another function I am writing here, a function returning multiple values. So far you have studied a function was returning only single value. Here I am writing two functions returning multiple values. Def square underscore cube of x. इसका मतलब मैं square cube नाम का function लिख रहा हूँ. एक parameter है इसमें x के नाम से. On the basis of this x, s is being calculated x into x. That is x square. Q is being calculated x into x into x. That is x cube. So s and q both are being returned using return statement. That means this function is returning two values and taking one parameter. Now after this, another function I am writing, def calculator a comma b. Here two parameters are being taken, two formal parameters have been defined, then calculation is being done. The logic of the program: add equal to a plus b, sub equal to a minus b, mul equal to multiply equal to a my a into b, divide equal to a upon b, return add comma subtract comma multiply comma divide, means it is returning four value together. So either you will hold these four values in four variables, separate variables, or you can hold these four values in one variable called list or tuple. So that is better idea to hold these four values, because if there are 10 values, thousands of values, so you have to hold such values in some collection type variable. So that is list or tuple is the best suited for that. And here if it is returning two or three values, then we can take in three different variable, two different variables. All right. Now calling the first function square cube, it requires one argument. So in the main program I am taking one argument num, int input enter a number. So num में मैं input करा दूंगा कोई number for entering one value, and sq comma q cu, that means it is returning two value s and q. So for s I am taking a variable sq, for q I am taking a variable cu. It will return two values, and those two values will be assigned to sq and cu. So a square underscore cube, this is the name of the function being called. Within bracket, argument num is being passed. So after this, what do you see? Print output backslash n. मैंने new line में लाने के लिए किया है square. ये जरा format से मैंने कर दिया है, format function का use करके sq और cu की value print किया है. So you can view the output. Enter a number. I have entered 6. Output is coming square equal to 36, cube is equal to 216. So दो value return किया, इसको दो variables में मैंने assign कर दिया. That is sq and cu. Both the variables have been printed using print statement and getting this output. Now for calling this function calculator, it is returning four values. So first of all, these four values I will take in a variable. And if one variable is holding multiple values, that may be tuple or that may be list. So generally it becomes tuples automatically by default. So num1 and num2, two parameters are being passed in this function. So num1 and num2 I have taken as input. So calling the function calculator num1 comma num2, but it is returning four values. So I am not assigning in four different variable x comma y comma z comma w. Aisa kuch main char variable nahi le raha hu. I am taking only one variable, that is answer. So that means answer will hold four values. Since this function is returning four values, add, sub, multiply and divide. So four values are going to be stored in answer named variable. So that means answer may be tuple, may be list. So by default it is tuple. So print answer करने पर ये tuple print हुआ आपका, देखें यहाँ 50, 40, 225 and 9.0. So this is, these are the four answers. अगर आप इनको access करना चाहते हैं, for accessing the values stored in a list or in a tuple, we use for loop. For I in answer, print I. So one by one, all the values lying in the tuple answer, in the variable answer, will be accessed through print I, because I will hold first value, second value, third value and so on up to fourth value. So you can see the output. 50 is being printed, new line 40. This is the total of two values that I have entered, 45 and 5. I have entered 45 plus 5, 50, 45 minus 4, 5, 40. 45 plus 5 is 50, 45 minus 5 is 40, 45 into 5 is 225, 45 divided by 5 is 9.0. Since we are using division, that is why it will be float. So this is the way how we can create a function which can return multiple values, and how those multiple values can be obtained during calling the function. It can be obtained in different variables or in a variable of collection type. So that's all about this type of function returning multiple values. Now after this we have parameters and arguments. As I have already explained what is parameter and what is argument, these are the values provided in the parenthesis in the function definition. Function definition mein ye jo aap likhte hain, ye parameters hain. And argument is a value or values that is passed to the function during function call. Function is being called over here, and these variables or arguments are known as arguments. Then actual parameters and formal parameters. In the function definition, whatever parameters are being defined, PRT here, are formal parameters. While calling the function, these arguments, these parameters are known as actual parameters. Now, there are various types of arguments also, four types of arguments. Number one, positional. number 2 default arguments, number 3 is one is variable length argument, and one is keyword arguments. So we will study one by one with example. Positional arguments, they are passed to the function in correct positional order. Here there are two arguments, d and t. So first, while calling this function, pahli jo value hogi, pahli position par, that will be the value of d. And the argument passed second argument will be against the position of t. That is why it is called as positional arguments. In case of positional arguments, we must give all arguments, as many arguments as defined in the function. If you give single argument out of d and t, it will not work, it will give an error. So I have to issue both the values during calling this function, the value of d as well as the value of t also. So here I have called a speed function giving value of d 25 and value of t as 3, because first value first position, second value second position, t's position. So it is being calculated 8.33 and so on. Once I give only one argument, one position argument, speed 20, so giving the value of d suppose, but not giving the value of t, and that is why it is displaying error. So while calling function, number and position of arguments must match, number of arguments as well as position of argument must match, otherwise it will result an error. That is why error is coming out. Now come to default arguments. It assumes a default value. If a value is not provided in the function call for that argument, agar kisi argument ki value function call mein na provide ki jaye, to wo already jo hai usme define kar di jati hai while writing the function itself. So that is default argument. Means here the value of d is equal to 100 by default. If we don't issue the value of d during calling, so although I have to give the value of both the parameters, but out of these two parameters, agar main t ki value nahi deta hu ya dono ki value nahi deta hu, so default value will automatically be taken and accordingly calculation will be done and it will return the value. Now they are not returning function here. I have defined two parameters, d equal to 100 and t equal to 20 has been defined here by default. And if we call this function speed without any argument, so it will take default arguments d equal to 100 and t equal to 20, thereby calculating 5.0, speed equal to 5.0. Suppose I have given only one argument during calling the function, so this argument will be considered for the first position, yani ki this is the value of d because it is first argument. So in place of 100, it will be overwritten by 200, and t will be same. So 200 divided by 20 is coming 10. So that way you are getting speed is equal to 10. Here in third one, we are issuing, giving both the arguments. So both the arguments latest value will be overwritten with the default, to the default value. That means 100 will be overwritten by 200 and 20 will be overwritten by 14. So thereby it will calculate 20 upon 14, coming 14 point something something. So the value of argument which is not provided in the function calling is taking default value. Jo function calling mein value aap nahi denge, wo default value utha lega from the body of the function. So they are default arguments. Now let us move to keyword arguments. Here you can see the same function I have written using d comma t, distance and time, calculating the speed. So if I call this function speed d equal to 50 and t equal to 4, so here d is the keyword of this parameter and t is the keyword of second parameter. So keyword must match. T ko aap time nahi kar sakte yahan while calling, d ko aap distance nahi kar sakte yahan while calling this function. D should be d only because it is a keyword of this function. speed. So d key value you have given 50, the value of t has been given 4. It is valid statement. It will calculate, I mean this 5.0. So 50 upon distance upon time. So 50 upon 4 is 5.0. Something wrong. 4 5s are 20 hota hai. So calculation mistake somewhere. जो आउटपुट मैंने यहाँ क्रॉप किया है देयर माइट बी सम प्रॉब्लम. ओके नाउ टी इज 4 एंड डी इज 50. सो यहाँ पर आप क्या देंगे, टी इक्वल टू 4 एंड डी इक्वल टू 50. टी के साथ ही आपको ये वैल्यू देनी है, डी के साथ ही आपको ये वैल्यू देनी है. इसको आपने वैल्यू एक्सचेंज भी अगर कर देते हैं, बिकॉज यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग द एक्चुअल वैल्यू विद द argument, sorry, this keyword, that is why it is not error. So it is speed is equal to 10.0. I don't know why this wrong answer is coming out. We'll see and clarify. Speed is equal to 200 and t is equal to 14. Here this one is keyword argument given, and this is the positional argument given. So first of all we have to, agar main dono mix karke dena chahta hu, so first positional argument has to be given, then thereafter it should be followed by keyword argument. It does not mean ki first keyword argument and then positional argument should be given, otherwise here it was giving the error. Understand? So we should take care that first keyword argument and then positional argument should not be given. First it should be positional, then followed by keyword argument. In such cases can be given. So this is about keyword argument. Now after this variable length argument, in a certain situation we can pass variable number of arguments to the function. वेरिएबल नंबर ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट का मतलब कभी एक आर्ग्यूमेंट से काम होता है, कभी दो आर्ग्यूमेंट से, कभी चार आर्ग्यूमेंट से, कभी 10 आर्ग्यूमेंट से, कहीं एरर नहीं आएगी. सो सच टाइप ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर कॉल्ड वेरिएबल लेंथ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स. इट इज डिक्लेयर्ड इन द फंक्शन डेफिनेशन प्री फिक्स्ड विद एस्ट्रिक्स कैरेक्टर. मतलब ऐसे आर्ग्यूमेंट्स को हम एस्ट्रिक्स कैरेक्टर के साथ फंक्शन डेफिनेशन में डिफाइन करते हैं. लाइक यू कैन सी द एग्जाम्पल डेफ avg स्टार n. This star n is a variable length argument. Means n की एक value दोगे तब भी आपका function काम करना चाहिए. n की दो value देंगे, चार value देंगे, 10 value देंगे, then also the function should work as it is. Now here what I am doing, sum equal to 0, counter equal to 0 for i in n. For i in n, n में एक वैल्यू भी हो सकती है, n में 10 वैल्यू भी हो सकती है. अगर एक वैल्यू होगी तो 10 वैल्यू होगी, तो फॉर i इन n इट विल वर्क लाइक ए टपल. सो फॉर i इन n, सम इक्वल टू सम प्लस i, सम 1 इक्वल टू सम 1 प्लस i. दिस इज ऑल द वैल्यूज आर बीइंग एडेड एंड c इज काउंटिंग नंबर ऑफ वैल्यूज, कितनी वैल्यूज हैं उसके अंदर, एंड इट इज फाइंडिंग आउट द एवरेज. एवरेज इज इक्वल टू सम 1 अपॉन c. सम जितना आ गया डिवाइडेड बाय सी, सी इज काउंटिंग हाउ मेनी वैल्यूज आर देयर, एंड देन एवरेज इक्वल टू ए वी, एवरेज इज बीइंग प्रिंटेड. सपोज वी गिव ए वी जी 20 व्हाइल कॉलिंग दिस फंक्शन. अगर मैं कॉल में लिखूं ए वी जी ऑफ 20, सो 20 का जो एवरेज होगा दैट इज 1 वैल्यू डिवाइडेड बाय 1, दैट इज 20 ओनली. ए वी जी ऑफ 15 एंड 20, सो इट इज गिविंग 17.5. ए वी जी ऑफ 15, 20, 25, 40 एंड 60 giving 32.0. that means either we giving one parameter or two parameters or multiple parameters. So length of the argument is varying. Here one argument, here two argument, here five arguments. That is why it is called as variable length arguments. Length of the arguments, number of arguments is increasing, decreasing or varying. That is why it is variable length argument. So these are various types of arguments. You might have understood how to write the functions. while writing keyword arguments that we have done earlier, keyword argument, this one, third one. So this is the point to remember, using the function with keyword argument is easier, as we do not need to remember the order of the arguments, because हमें ऑर्डर नहीं पता रखना पड़ेगा. d इज इक्वल टू 50, t इज इक्वल टू 4. सो यू आर जस्ट गिविंग d इज इक्वल टू एंड t इज इक्वल टू, सो नथिंग एल्स. t इज इक्वल टू दिस, d इज इक्वल टू दिस, लाइक दैट यू आर गिविंग द कीवर्ड, एंड द कीवर्ड ऑफ द कॉलिंग प्रोग्राम मस्ट मैच विद द फंक्शन प्रोग्राम. Now we can specify values of only those parameters which we want to. Other parameters have default arguments. जिसकी value आप देना चाहते हैं दे सकते हैं, दूसरा जो parameter है वो default value होगी उसकी. अगर मैं यहाँ 200 दे रहा हूँ तो this is the default value. T की value 14 दे रहा हूँ, so 14 is being taken as a value of T, and 20 यहाँ पर positional parameter ले रहा है. It is taking positional parameter. So these are the things that we should know about various types of arguments. Char tarah ke arguments aapne padhe, and that's all about this video, user defined functions. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much. We'll meet again in the new coming video with new topic. Till then, stay home and be safe. Thank you.